Bryce, congratulations on this film. I know that you premiered it last year at the Toronto International Film Festival with great applause, great reception. You must have just been so thrilled with how everybody took it in.
I mean, that was awesome that night at TIFF, getting to share the film for the first time. I have to admit, about 24 hours before the screening, I started panicking because I was like, what have I done? I made a documentary that opens with my birth. Like, I have spent my entire life just trying to not like upset anyone or whatever and not like, ugh. And then I opened a documentary with my birth. Like, why would I give myself a bullseye like that? But it was just such a great experience, and getting to have my dad there, and
yes,
you know, we all know Canadians are the best. So it's just, it was great. It was like, I was very, very, very scared and suddenly like super worried. And then to have that warmth and to just be received in that way was like, was such a relief, honestly.
Yeah, I don't think you had anything to worry about, especially with, you know, this is such a wonderful film, and thank you for it, because I don't think you could have had better role models than your father and your grandfather. You know, they're next level people, honestly. But what was it when you decided to do this? What was Ron's initial reaction? Because I think like he was probably like, yeah, I don't know, what are you doing?
Yeah, he was. Yeah, my dad was really concerned about me doing this, because I'm a very enthusiastic person, and I love my parents, and I'm very vocal about that. And my dad is always to me, he's like, Bryce, I'm going to get knocked off that pedestal one day, and it's going to be a brutal fall now that now I'm 39 years old. he's like, you know, don't have this, no one's going to want to see the Bryce Loves Her Dad movie. Like, please don't do that.
Understood. Yeah.
And there's so much story without the Howard family, you know, like there's so many great dads out there. And,
absolutely.
And so I got that. But I kept wanting to have an expecting father. And then when my brother and his wife got pregnant, and I was like, hello, here's my expecting father. It was more organic. It made sense. And my dad was ultimately supportive of it. But after the screening, after the TIFF screening, he was over the moon. I've never seen him so excited in my entire life. But he did say, I still think I'm in the movie too much.
Well, that's your dad. I mean, listen, yeah. I've had the privilege of meeting him and interviewing him many times, and he's just such a wonderful person. You know, what I love so much about this is not only that you get some celebrity dads, that's great. You always, listen, we have to have the flash and see what they, you know, I love watching Jimmy Fallon and Jimmy Kimmel right now, because we really get to see behind the scenes of how, what great dads they are. Honestly, it's beyond. I wish they do this forever. But you also have real life dads, of course, as you were mentioning, and what makes it so real for us. So thank you for doing that, because really you've given us such a good balance. Was it hard for you to do that balance, or did it just flow naturally?
Oh gosh, no, thank you, Bonnie. I at the genesis of the idea, I really wanted to interview stand-up comedians and for them to be our Greek chorus. And to not get into their lives, like pictures of their kids, like all that kind of stuff, like truly for them to be speaking to the universal experience of fathering, but from, of course, their own perspective. And then I wanted to dive into the daddy blogger community and find fathers who were already capturing and sharing their stories and their family stories. Yeah. And the thing that, I shouldn't say I was surprised by this, but I mean, there were just so many remarkable heroic fathers, and so many great comedian dads as well. It was difficult to narrow it down, honestly, because it was like every person that we weren't telling their story was like a loss, but it was like, but they're so amazing. You know, they deserve to be celebrated. And so it's, that was the balance that was really important for me. The thing that was kind of the wild card, I think, was the Howard family storyline, that it was like, what's this? I'm like, how are we gonna like weave this throughout it? You know, but it was fun.
Yeah, well, you've done a beautiful, beautiful job. And this is perfect for Father's Day, of course. And you know, after all, after it's all said and done, you know, I just hope you have learned something, maybe just not only about your own family, but your own husband, too, as a dad. And that's probably really important as well.
Absolutely. I mean, it's really interesting because, like, as in my journey of becoming a mother, you know, it's like it's a form of an identity crisis. You are becoming something new that never existed before. But that process, as isolating as it can feel, I still had a rite of passage. I was still acknowledged for being the, you know, oftentimes the like primary caregiver of my child and children. When the reality was that my husband was just as involved as I was. And, you know, many times, if not more. Right. And I think seeing how much he, like realizing the lack of public acknowledgement and the assumption that anything great that my kids were doing were because of me, not because of us. You know, it was my kids rather than our kids. And it was eye opening in that regard, being like, why didn't I have a baby shower for you, Seth? Like, you're a dad too. Like, yeah, I got to push the baby out. Like, you know, for sure. Like, pat me on the back. Definitely. But don't ignore you.
Exactly.
Why?
So much. So. Yeah, absolutely. It just, listen, thank you so much for your time. Beautiful, beautiful film. I can't wait to see what you do next. And then the next time you come to the Toronto Film Festival with your next film. Okay?
Thank you, Bonnie.
Have a good one. So. Thanks, Bryce. Thanks for your time. Okay, take care. Bye-bye.
You too. Bye.
That's a cut.